Hello viewers, today we are going to learn consumer protection. You have studied the meaning of consumer protection, the problems faced by the consumers like adulteration of materials, sale of spurious products, sale of substandard products, hoarding and black marketing, etc. We have studied the need for consumer protection as well as the parties involved in consumer protection like the consumers, business persons and government. Now let me discuss the legal aspects that is available in the country to protect the consumers. The laws that is prevailing in the society to protect the consumers. Let us discuss it one by one. First law is the Agricultural Products Grading and Marketing Act of 1937. As per this act, agricultural commodities are graded and sorted and marks are given like UG mark with the help of Agricultural Marketing Department under the control of the government. So this act helped to grade the agricultural products so that the farmers will get high value for their product and the consumers will get good products. And UG mark seal is being imposed for that product. Next law that is there to protect the consumer is the Industries Development and Regulation Act of 1951. This act helped to control the production and distribution of products in the case of industries. The government can order for investigation if they find that there is a decline in the quality of any product or unreasonable rise in price of any product or a drastic decline in the volume of production. In such cases, government can order for investigation for the reason why these things occurred. And after evaluation, government should take steps to rectify that and can direct those industries to deal in a particular manner to help the consumers. If that particular industry is not acting as per the directions of the government, then the government can take over such industry so that the consumers are being protected with the help of this act also. Now let us discuss prevention of Food Adulteration Act 1954. This act gives severe punishment to the persons who are engaging in the selling of adulterated materials. Sale of adulterated materials will lead to lifetime imprisonment and a penalty of ₹3,000 as minimum is payable to the government. The selling as well as storing, importing of the adulterated material is a serious crime and that industries are supposed to give penalty according to the orders of the court. So, food is not being adulterated or prevention of adulteration is possible with the help of this act, Prevention of Food Adulteration Act of 1954. Now let us discuss another act which is also helping the consumers, that is Essential Commodities Act of 1955. Certain commodities can be declared as essential at any time by the government and government can supply and control and distribute such products if necessary in order to make such products available in the market. So certain products will be declared as essential by the government by considering the interest of the society, so that its control, supply and distribution will be under the hands of government. Another act which is helping the consumers is the Standard Weights and Measures Act of 1956. Before this act, people in our country use different weights and measures. For measuring weights, they had used pounds, sear, etc. For measuring the length, they had used inches, yards, etc. There is no Standard Weights and Measures at that time. And after the enactment of this act in 1956, throughout the country, standard weights and measures are being used. Primary unit for measuring weight is the kilogram, and primary unit for measuring the length is meter. As a result of this act, the consumers are not being exploited, because the consumers will get standard weights and measures as per the act, products containing the standard weights and measures. Another act protecting the consumers include Monopolies and Restrictive Trade Practices Act of 1969. This act helps the consumers to seek redressal while filing complaints in the courts relating to the unfair business practices or restrictive business practices prevailing in the society. And MRTP Act helps the consumers to protect from the business malpractices prevailing in the society. Another act that is helping the consumers include Prevention of Black Marketing and Maintenance of Essential Supplies Act of 1980. In most of the cases, consumers are being exploited by using black marketing. That is, the dealers will keep the products and will not made it available in the market. And after a certain time, they will sell it at a high price. The hoarded products are being sold at a high price, and that is known as marketing. And as a result of this act, similarly, essential commodities are supplied in the market without any delay, because if the dealers are retaining certain products which are essential to the market, then the dealers have to pay penalty for the practices like black marketing and retaining goods that is essential in the market. Similarly, the hoarding practices can be prevented up to some extent with the help of these acts. Now let us discuss Bureau of Indian Standards Act of 1986. It came into force after replacing Indian Standard Institution. And the main function of this Bureau of Indian Standard is to protect the consumers and to formulate quality standard for the goods. Next function that is done by this organization include giving certification mark to certain manufacturers to use ISI mark along with their product. That is being allowed only after verifying the product in conformity with the quality of the product, performance of the product, and the volume quality with regard to the performance and volume. And then ISM mark will be distributed to the manufacturers by the Bureau of Indian Standards. So here also consumers are being protected, and Consumer Affairs Department is there along with that, that will deal with the complaints of the consumers, and consumers can go with the complaint to these department if they have any complaint relating to the product which has certain ISI mark. Next act is the Consumer Protection Act of 1986. This act gives more importance to the consumers. It is protecting the consumers with respect to the goods and with respect to the services like banking, transportation, boarding and lodging, housing, entertainment, etc. And as per this act, there is a provision to form Consumer Protection Council, and this act set up consumer courts or semi-judicial system. This semi-judicial system gives protection to the consumers at three levels: district level, state level, and national level. In the district level, they have formed district forum. In the state level, they have formed state consumer dispute redressal commission. In the national level, this consumer court includes National Consumer Dispute Redressal Commission, or it can be called as the National Commission. In the district forum, the consumers can file the complaints where the value of the goods or services or compensation will come up to rupees 20 lakh, or there is a claim for compensation up to rupees 20 lakh. In the state commission, consumers can file the case if the value of the goods or services or complaints are within the range of 20 lakh and 1 crore. In the national commission, consumers can file the case if the value of the products or services or claims are beyond 1 crore. And the consumers who are not satisfied with the verdict of the district forum can go for appeal in the state commission. Against the orders of the state commission, the consumers can appeal in the national commission. If the consumers are not satisfied even with the national commission, they can go to the Supreme Court for getting the final decision. Dear learners, you have studied various laws are framed by the government to protect the consumers, including the Consumer Protection Act of 1986, which helped to the formation of semi-judicial system consisting of consumer courts. And consumer courts help the consumers to settle their disputes and to get compensation for the losses they had suffered. Dear learners, look into your textbook and study the portions thoroughly and have an idea about the consumer protection.
प्रकाशित करने, राहों को आलोकित करने, हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने, हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने।
भी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय के लोच से युक्त हो मित्रों हम उठे और जागे
viewers, today we are going to learn consumer protection. You have studied the meaning of consumer protection, the problems faced by the consumers like adulteration of materials, sale of spurious products, sale of substandard products, hoarding and black marketing, etc. We have studied the need for consumer protection as well as the parties involved in consumer protection like the consumers, business persons and government. And various laws are framed by the government to protect the consumers, including the Consumer Protection Act of 1986, which helped to the formation of semi-judicial system consisting of consumer courts. And consumer courts helped the consumers to settle their disputes and to get compensation for the losses they had suffered. Now, procedure for redressal of consumer grievances. Consumers have to file the complaint either independently or through associations. Consumers can file through an authorized agent. And minimum fee is to be paid for filing the complaint. Along with the complaint, consumers should include certain other information. And the complaint should be filed in 5 copies. The information that should be attached along with the complaint include name, address, and description of the complainant. Name, address and description of the opposite party. Reasons for the complaint or the facts of complaint should be clearly laid down. Then any document to support your complaint like the receipt or vouchers can be attached along with that. Then the complaints should be signed by this complainant. The amount or the remedies seeking should be clearly mentioned in the complaint. The complainant should post the complaint or can directly give to the district forum, state commission or national commission. It should be addressed to the president of the district forum or state commission or national commission. and the complaint should be filed within 2 years. Otherwise, the reason for the delay must be recorded and the decision for the complaint should be made within 3 months from the date of receival of the complaint by the opposite party, by the date of receival of notice by the opposite party. After the opposite party receives the notice from the complainant, then within 3 months, decision should be taken by the consumer court. In the case of lab analysis, then the period can be extended for 5 more months. So, the verdict should come within 5 months. So, that is the procedure for redressal of consumer grievances. Now, we have learned various laws prevailing in our country in order to protect the consumers, like MRTP Act, Consumer Protection Act, Prevention of Adulteration of Food Materials Act, etc. Now, you have an idea relating to the laws that is prevailing, and if any complaint occurs, you can approach these authorities as you are aware of the Act. You are also aware of the consumer codes that is there in our country, and if any complaint arises relating to any product that you have purchased, you can go either to the district forum or state commission or national commission. Now, let us study the role of non-governmental organizations in consumer protection. Non-governmental organizations are voluntary organizations formed to protect the interest of the persons living in our society. They have their own constitutions and laws, and they are funded partly by the government and from the assistance of the public. In the form of donations, public will assist these NGOs. And NGOs formed to protect the consumers can be called as consumer associations. So, consumer associations play an important role in protecting the interest of consumers. Let us discuss it one by one. Consumers organizations or consumer associations create awareness among the consumers. NGOs or consumer associations will educate the consumers about the rights prevailing in the society or the laws prevailing in the society in order to exercise the rights of the consumers or remedies they can get from various codes that is being informed by the NGOs. NGOs are providing legal aid to consumers. They are giving legal support to the consumers in certain cases. NGOs act as representative members of consumer protection councils while making the laws of the government in order to protect the consumers. NGOs will act as a representative of consumer. They will give the suggestions to the government while framing different laws to protect the consumers. NGOs will arrange comparative testing of consumer products in their laboratory. If the products available in the market are not up to the quality, NGOs will make certain arrangements to test those products. NGOs will publish periodicals and journals, and in that they include materials relating to consumer problems, the remedies available in the society, and the persons to whom these consumers should go for. These matters are being informed through their publications and journals. While framing various amendments in the laws made by the government, consumers will give their recommendations. Consumers will suggest certain steps for improving the performance of the producers in order to protect the consumers. So, NGOs plays an important role in protecting the consumers, and they have no intention to make any profit. And that is about consumer protection. Dear learners, you have studied the meaning of consumer protection, the problems faced by the consumers like adulteration of materials, sale of spurious products, sale of substandard products, hoarding and black marketing, etc. We have studied the need for consumer protection as well as the parties involved in consumer protection like the consumers, business persons and government. And various laws are framed by the government to protect the consumers, including the Consumer Protection Act of 1986, which helped to the formation of semi-judicial system consisting of consumer courts. And consumer courts help the consumers to settle their disputes and to get compensation for the losses they had suffered. And finally, we have studied the role of NGOs or role of consumer organizations. Dear learners, look into your textbook and study the portions thoroughly and have an idea about the consumer protection.
प्रकाशित करने रावों को आलोकित करने
हम अपना दीपक स्वयं बने हम अपना रास्ता स्वयं चुने
कभी पढ़े हम कहीं पढ़े वे विषय की लोच से यूं